If Edward Snowden comes to Cuba, he would not be the first U.S. fugitive to find refuge on this island. U.S. officials say dozens of American fugitives are believed to be living under the Cuban government's protection. William Potts was a Black Panther who used a gun to hijack a plane and take it from New Jersey to Havana. But instead of the military training he hoped the Cubans would offer a fellow revolutionary, Potts received more than 13 years in prison.
In a Machiavellian sense, the Cubans changed. They simply changed.
Potts still lives in Cuba, although now he is trying to convince U.S. officials to let him return home. Asada Shakur, a Black Power militant, received a warmer greeting in Cuba. After being convicted of gunning down a New Jersey state trooper in 1973 and then breaking out of prison, Shakur was granted asylum in Cuba. Then Cuban leader Fidel Castro said Shakur had been a political prisoner in the U.S. Until recently, she made frequent public appearances and even starred in the Cuban documentary Eyes of the Rainbow.
You know, I was like expecting, first of all, everybody to look like Fidel. I thought everybody was going to wear green fatigues and stuff. It was just like a crazy thing, and I thought people would be talking like the revolution.
In May, U.S. officials raised the reward for Shakur to $2 million.
We are raising the reward from $1 million to $2 million for the successful apprehension of this convicted murderer.
Snowden wouldn't even be the first U.S. spy to receive safe haven in Cuba. Like Snowden, ex-CIA officer Philip Agee exposed American intelligence operations, blowing the covers of dozens of operatives. Agee also went on the run, eventually making it to Havana, where he opened a travel agency. He died here in 2008.
The whole idea is to take a chance. I mean, what's fun in life if you're not taking a chance? I've been taking chances for a long, long time. I took a lot of chances when I was in the CIA.
More recent attempts by U.S. fugitives to live on the lam in Cuba haven't been as successful. In April, a Florida couple wanted in the U.S. on drug and kidnapping charges were sent back by Cuban authorities after fleeing to the island in this boat. During the Cold War, Cuba built monuments to honor Julius and Ethel Rosenberg, executed in the United States for spying. But recently, Cuban President Raul Castro has said he would like better relations with the United States, hopes that most likely will be derailed if Edward Snowden comes to Cuba. But if Cuba takes in Snowden, U.S. officials would have a hard time getting him back. Cuban officials accuse the U.S. of harboring fugitives, even terrorists, wanted in Cuba. Snowden, though, hasn't been spotted on the six times a week Moscow to Havana direct flights. At least, not yet. Patrick Ottman, CNN Havana.